Modern medicine is full of many success stories, but here's one you may not have heard about: our ability to detect and treat ectopic pregnancy. For most of human history, ectopic pregnancies were fatal. Now the risk of death from ectopic pregnancies is less than 1 in 1,000. Although that risk of death is now extremely low, catching ectopic pregnancies early remains key to being able to treat them in such a way that saves lives and maintains fertility. This is why it's important to understand what ectopic pregnancies are, their risk factors, and what symptoms to look out for. This video will cover these topics, as well as the treatment options that have made this such a medical success. So, what are ectopic pregnancies? Ectopic pregnancies are what happens when a fertilized egg implants in an area outside of the uterus. In order to understand what this means, it may be helpful to first understand what a normal pregnancy would look like. Normally, we'd expect an egg to be released by the ovaries, be fertilized in the fallopian tubes, and then travel to the uterus, where it implants in the lining known as the endometrium. The uterus and this lining is specialized to be able to support healthy development of an embryo. About 1 or 2 out of 100 pregnancies, an egg implants somewhere else instead, like in the fallopian tubes, and we get an ectopic pregnancy. A fertilized egg cannot fully develop outside of the uterus, and therefore an ectopic pregnancy cannot be continued. Furthermore, other parts of the body are not equipped to support a growing pregnancy, which means that ectopic pregnancies can become life-threatening to the pregnant person if left untreated. Now that you know what an ectopic pregnancy is, you may be wondering who's at risk for one. Ectopic pregnancies can happen to anyone, but there are a few risk factors that may increase your chances of having one. The most significant risk factor is having had a prior ectopic pregnancy. If you've had an ectopic pregnancy in the past, your chance of it happening again is about 10 times higher. Other things that increase your chances are smoking, your age, use of fertility treatments, a history of a pelvic infection or PID, and a history of surgery on your fallopian tubes. Finally, although the risk of getting pregnant while using an IUD as contraception is very low, less than 1 out of 100, if a pregnancy does happen while you have an IUD, there's a greater chance of it being an ectopic pregnancy. So what are the symptoms of an ectopic pregnancy? There are 3 classic symptoms that are often seen together in an ectopic pregnancy: abdominal pain, vaginal bleeding, and a missed period. However, there are times when pain is the only symptom, or when these symptoms may be present but there isn't an ectopic pregnancy. Ectopic pregnancies are therefore diagnosed through certain tests instead of by symptoms alone. These tests include urine and blood tests for the pregnancy hormone beta-HCG and an ultrasound of the uterus and ovaries. Now that we understand a little bit more about ectopic pregnancies, we can discuss how they are treated. There are a few different types of treatment of ectopic pregnancy, and which ones are used can depend on many factors, including someone's fertility goals and the level of immediate danger. Ectopic pregnancies may be treated through surgery, medication, or a combination of both. Let's start with talking about some surgical procedures that may be used to treat an ectopic pregnancy. The surgical options differ in the size of the incision and whether or not the fallopian tube is left in place. If the ectopic pregnancy has significantly damaged the fallopian tube, the tube may have to be removed. This can also often be done through a small incision using a camera called a laparoscope. Although surgery for an ectopic pregnancy often removes a fallopian tube, as long as the other tube is present and healthy, it is still possible to become pregnant in the future. In some cases, if the fallopian tube has not been significantly harmed by the ectopic pregnancy, your surgeon may be able to remove the ectopic pregnancy through an incision in the tube while leaving the tube in place. The most significant risk with this treatment option is that the ectopic pregnancy might not be cleared completely, and that the tube is left at a higher risk for having a future ectopic pregnancy. To account for this risk, your levels of beta-HCG might need to be monitored over a period of time after the surgery to ensure the pregnancy is gone and no longer a risk to your health. If the ectopic pregnancy is small enough, and you are able to come back for multiple blood tests, and your provider thinks it's safe for you, treatment through medication may be an option. The medication that is used is called methotrexate. This medication may also be used after surgery if the pregnancy is not completely removed with the surgery. This treatment may not be an option if you are breastfeeding or have certain other medical conditions. There are also times when your healthcare provider may not be certain that you have an ectopic pregnancy. This typically occurs in the first 6 weeks of pregnancy when it's not clear whether you have a normal pregnancy, an ectopic pregnancy, or a miscarriage. This is called a pregnancy of unknown location and requires following your pregnancy hormone closely. Ectopic pregnancies have the potential to be dangerous, but with modern medicine are very treatable. If you have questions regarding ectopic pregnancy, or you are pregnant and having bleeding, be sure to see your doctor.